Hello friends, today we will review chapter 2 from Modern Software Engineering written by David Farley. In chapter 1 we reviewed, when we think of software engineering, we think of big bureaucratic controls, lot of documentation about very few lines of code, meetings about meetings, no real coding done. Glenn Vandenberg nicely said, old software engineering worked because some very passionate, smart people were able to bypass it. So that's what Dave Farley is coming, that we need to come with a new definition of software engineering. Software engineering which allows you to do the real work. Let me again repeat his definition of software engineering. Engineering is the application of an empirical scientific approach to finding efficient economic solutions to practical problems. So whenever you talk about software engineering, there are people who will laugh at you and they will say it's not building bridges, it's not like building buildings. In buildings, you cannot build second floor without building foundation, first floor, whereas in software, a lot of things are possible. So Dave Farley says a lot of people confuse software engineering with production engineering. There are two types of engineering. One is design engineering, and then one is production engineering. When you are building bridges or other, you're building some components of some car, vehicle, that is production engineering. It takes a lot of effort in another engineering efforts to build a prototype and take this prototype to a mass production. Dave Farley says that in software we are lucky, and moving something which is working in development test should not be a big hard thing to move to production. And if it is happening, you have some real issues at hand. He says waterfall methodology is production engineering thinking. I know personally a lot of projects we developed for 6 months, 7 months, we did in waterfall, we moved into production, and production it could not scale because people did not do proper scalability stress testing. And I have seen software failing because they worked in development and test environment, but in production, they just refused to scale up the demands of the users. Whereas in agile programming, you are working in iteration, you are moving your software regularly to production, you are validating whatever you built is working in production. Another thing is that in other engineering disciplines, the cost of failure is too much. If you are building a new bridge, you have to build a model, you have to build a mathematical computations to test the strength of your bridge. For example, SpaceX. SpaceX is blowing up its rockets to understand the technology, to understand the rocket technology. SpaceX has a lot of data about their material, about their technology, what are the different variables, and still things go wrong. In software, we are lucky that we don't have generally production problem. If we are following agile methodology properly, pushing a build from dev to test to production should be a matter of one click. So we don't have to worry about building models and testing the models. We can start away, build our application, take a small part, do experimentation, discovery, development, design. Our is more design engineering. So we can start building a product, validating the concept, take the portion which is very important to customers, and make sure that we build something and we push to production as fast as possible. Another thing is, a lot of people think code is engineering. Code is not engineering. Like, it's like SpaceX, rocket is not the engineering. The process of building rocket is engineering. Same way Dave Farley says, The process of building code is engineering. Engineering is the processes, methodologies, and framework which help you to produce software is engineering. So here we are trying to come up with some principles which have worked for the industry, which we can take it from this book, which we can take from this book. A lot of people say software programming is craftsmanship. But in David Farley, in second chapter, argues why we need to treat software development as engineering, not as craftsmanship. In craftsmanship, you produce, every product is different than another product. In craftsmanship, like my cousin asked me to pick up some clothes she has given to a craftsman for some work on her clothes. And I asked her how I will know that it is handmade work. She said there should be some imperfectional. She said it should not be clean. It should be imperfected. And that is craftsman work. And you pay it more than work done by machine. So that is the problem with the software. That is the problem if we treat software programming as craftsmanship. We need more precision. We need more scalability. We need repeatability. So we need some principles, some processes, some methods which we can teach, which we can teach to students in the colleges, so that they come when they start working on the projects, they are ready. So friends, if you like this video, watch my other videos in Modern Software Engineering playlist. Also like it, share it, and subscribe to my channel for your regular updates. Connect with me on LinkedIn and Twitter, especially LinkedIn if you like small summaries of the video. I will be posting a lot of small summaries of the video on LinkedIn. Thanks again.